I'm Lori Hart, the Global Product Marketing Manager for Advanced Analytics. And joining me today is Ed Hughes, the Product Manager for SAS Optimization. Ed, thanks for talking with me today.
Glad to be here, Lori.
A few years ago, Harvard Business Review had a great article on how big data and analytics have rocketed to the top of the corporate agenda. Organizations have moved away from just using sophisticated algorithms as a supplement to changes or enhancements in business processes to being the primary source. Ed, I would like to get your thoughts on how optimization plays a key role in that trend as it applies to key business decisions and the analytics lifecycle.
Optimization is very important because it enhances your analytics capabilities beyond the more passive, descriptive, and predictive analytics to prescriptive analytics that actively identify optimal courses of action. Optimization gives you a structured, consistent, repeatable, and adaptable way to use that information that other forms of analytics provide to evaluate and improve your decision-making.
Optimization can provide many key benefits for an organization. For example, by finding smarter ways to allocate limited resources. Can you give an example of that in SAS?
Sure, Lori. We completed a project with DBS Singapore, a large bank with a network of some 1,500 ATMs. They were looking for a more efficient and less costly way to replenish the cash in their ATMs. We used a combination of forecasting and optimization to get a better grasp on the hourly demand profile at each ATM and to devise optimal replenishment plans. The optimization model runs nightly, and its recommendations virtually eliminate cash outages at ATMs, all while reducing replenishment trips by 14% and saving almost $1.5 million annually.
So that was an example of an optimization problem with embedded network structure of nodes and connecting links. How does SAS optimization help its users deal with network structures and data?
SAS optimization includes an entire class of CAS actions for analyzing network structures and solving network-oriented optimization problems. You can do things like identify the connected components of a network or solve a minimum cost network flow problem that uses supply at some nodes to satisfy demand at others. You can identify paths between two specific origin and destination nodes, between one origin and all possible destinations, or between all possible origins and one destination. Here's a quick example. In this example, we're using the new path enumeration algorithm, called from ProcOp Network in SAS Optimization. This dataset describes the network. For each link that connects two nodes, it lists the node on each end of the link. This is a directed network, so each link originates at a from node and terminates at a to node. The dataset also includes the weight of each link, which we could interpret as length or cost, for example. We want to find all paths that start at node D and end at node A. We're going to cap the total weight of each path at 10 so that we don't produce too many paths to deal with. The ProcOp network code reads in the directed network data, selects the path enumeration algorithm, and specifies D as the starting node and A as the ending node for each path. The option max link weight equals 10 limits the total weight of each path. Let's run this program. We print out two output data sets, one for the links on the paths and one for the nodes on the paths. The algorithm finds three paths with length 10 or lower. The third path has the most links. It goes from D to F, F to E, E to B, B to C, and finally from C to A. The other output data set lists the nodes on each path, and for the third path it shows in order D, F, E, B, C, and A. By the way, network optimization is just one of the elements of SAS optimization that use the distributed computation that SAS VIA makes possible. Distributed optimization means you can solve larger, more complex problems in a reasonable amount of time. And thanks to big data and improvements in other analytics, optimization problems are growing and becoming more complex.
That's true. One other thing, in some practical uses of optimization, there's a single objective: minimize costs, maximize profit, minimize distance traveled, and so on. But what if there's more than one way to measure the value of a solution? What can we do then?
Well, as always in SAS optimization, there's more than one way to meet this challenge. Sometimes, for example, there's general agreement on the relative importance of the different performance metrics, and you can use that information to combine them into one objective function. But if there's no agreement on how the metrics stack up against each other, then you might want to try multi-objective optimization. Each metric is included as a distinct objective function. You can have as many objectives as you like for a single problem. When you can't decide how performance metrics compare in importance, you're going to need several alternative solutions to evaluate. So in multi-objective optimization, we look for an optimal set of solutions. For each one, no other solution produces better values for every objective function. These are called non-dominated solutions, and together they form a Pareto optimal frontier. Any solution in this set is optimal and is an excellent choice for implementation. One of the new features of SAS Optimization 8.2, the local search optimization, or LSO solver, can handle problems with very challenging functions, discontinuous, non-smooth, non-differentiable, and it can also perform multi-objective optimization. In this example, we use the local search optimization, or LSO solver, to execute a nonlinear optimization with two decision variables and two objective functions. We want to minimize both objective functions. We call the LSO solver from ProcOp model in SAS optimization. Here are the two nonlinear objective functions, each of which sums two square terms. This problem has no constraints except for the bounds on the decision variables. We specify solve with LSO, and we also specify objective F1, F2 to indicate that it's a multi-objective model. The last few ProcOp model commands after the solve statement catalog the Pareto optimal solutions and create an output data set that contains them. Finally, we use proc sgplot to graph this set of solutions. Let's run this program. The solution summary shows that the LSO solver looked at more than 22,000 points and found more than 4,900 non-dominated solutions. Here's the graph of the efficient frontier. Remember, we're minimizing both objectives, so we're pushing toward the lower left corner of the graph. And here are the first 100 rows of the data that describes these non-dominated solutions. In a practical application, you'd use your own criteria to filter these optimal solutions and decide which one to implement.
Here at SAS, we consider the use of optimization as a key component of the analytics lifecycle. These sophisticated algorithms not only manage limited resources effectively in a challenging world, but also can be used in any situation where improvements in the productivity of business are of paramount importance. Thanks for watching.